Hi everyone, so you might be having this smartphone in your pocket. This is Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus and it takes some great photos. Well, still it lacks something like good portrait mode photo and even the low light photos. So it has a single camera and then also it offers portrait mode, but it is not as appealing as other phones are doing right now. So this is one of the best smartphones of 2017. In 2018, most of the phones are having dual camera setup, but this phone lacks it. So it implies that you cannot take great portrait mode photos with a single camera setup. The answer is yes. But hold on a second. What about Google Pixel 2? Google Pixel 2 is also having a single camera setup, but it takes some great portrait mode photos and even some low light photos. So what is the difference between this phone and Google Pixel 2 and how it can take great portrait photo even though it is having the single camera setup as it is present in Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus? To know the answer, watch this video till the end. So without further delaying, let's dive in this video. So here comes the answer. It also doesn't mean that if you are having great camera hardware, it always takes some great photos. So what is missing is software. So the software of Google Pixel 2 is quite better when we are comparing with Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus. So it takes some great portrait mode photos and some low light photos. So here I'm going to tell you how you can install that customized Google Pixel app on the Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus or even S8, and it is backward compatible, so you can install it on Samsung Galaxy S7, S6 also. There's a one thing which you need to keep in mind. This is only applicable in Exynos version. So if you are having Snapdragon processor on your phone, then you cannot install this app and skip this video right now. So let's move to our desk and let's tell you how to install this app and how to customize it on this S8 phone. So here I'm gonna tell you how you can install this app. You need to visit your browser and then you need to download this file. You can download it anyway. You can install this app and you can download from there, or you can just open in browser and it will start downloading. You will see that I have downloaded this file already, so I'm not gonna do it. And I'm gonna show you that here the file will be something like that. So you can see here it shows that the file is here. You need to install this. For installing, you need the procedure. You just need to go install it, and the Google camera app will be installed in your phone. So once installed, you need to open this, and it's very simple. Just open the camera app, just assign the permissions which it is asking, and boom, we are in the camera mode. Before using this camera, you need to turn on some settings. Go to settings and then head to the advanced mode, and there you will find that configure your phone. So it's a Nexus 6 HDR Plus Auto. It will be something like that. Do not go for Pixel 2017 because it is not working in this phone, so keep it there only. And apart from that, you will find some more settings like correct base pattern and correct white label on S7 Exynos from cam. So if you are using Exynos version like I am using the Exynos version, keep the settings on. If not, then close these settings. So everything will be same. Do not touch any settings there. And you will find that the video setting quality will be also set already there, so you need not to turn on. Live HDR Samsung mode will be there, so just go back. And from here you can turn your HDR auto or on. I will turn it on, and then you can take some great portrait mode photos. Let me show you here. So here it comes. Boom, it's so easy. So it will take some processing time to process this photo in HDR mode, and once it's processed, you can see the difference. So this was the image which I have taken, and here's the image. So you can see that it has blurred the fan and all the background, so it gives you good portrait photo. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if it was useful, please give me a thumbs up. And if you didn't like this video, you know where the dislike button. And if it is your first time on my channel, please subscribe this channel and please hit the bell icon so that you receive notification whenever I make new videos. So thank you for watching, have a nice day, and catch you in the next video.